नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई जे वी इंदू असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन मैथोलॉजी जयोति विद्यापीठ विमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी. टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट सिस्टम बस. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. Before starting the discussion of system bus, first of all, we should know what is the meaning of bus. Bus is the set of lines. Bus is the set of lines. Bus is used to transfer information, and the information should be in the form of binary. So bus is a set of lines which is used to transfer information in the binary form. If line is connected to VCC, it means it will carry logic 1. If the line is connected to ground, it means it will carry logic 0. If the bus is connected to VCC, it means it will carry logic 1. If the line is connected to ground, it means it will carry logic 0. One bus can carry one bit. If we want to transmit number of bits, or we can say that if we want to transfer multiple bits, then we will use multiple lines. One line or one bus can carry one bit. These are two lines. It means these lines will carry 2 bits. These are 8 lines. It means these lines can carry 8 bits. So one bus can carry 1 bit at a time. And if we want to transmit multiple bits, then we have to use multiple buses or multiple lines. One line means one bus . Suppose if we draw 2 lines, and through this line, I said these are 8 lines. I draw 2 lines, then I cut these 2 lines and I write 8 bit. It means these are 8 lines, and 8 lines means they can carry 8 bit. There are 3 buses: address bus, data bus, and control bus. Collectively, these 3 buses are called system bus. So, first of all, I will draw the block diagram of the computer system. Then we will discuss about address bus, data bus, and control bus. So this is the block diagram of the computer system. Here there are 3 buses. First one is address bus, second one is data bus, and third one is control bus. Address bus is used to carry address where the operation has to be performed. Data bus is used to carry data, and control bus is used to carry control signals. Address bus is the unidirectional. Control bus is also unidirectional, and data bus is bidirectional. In the memory, there are loads of locations. Like this. These are the locations. These locations we divided these locations in the 2 columns. First column will be for the address, and second column will be for the data. Suppose the address of this location is 1000 and the data at 1000 location is 32. If now the processor wants to write at 1000 memory location 36, processor wants to write 36 at 1000 memory location. So first of all, processor will give the address 1000 on the address bus. After that, in the memory, 1000 memory location will be select. After that, processor will give 36 to the data bus. After that, processor will give the control signal through the control bus. Control signal means processor wants to write or read the data at a particular memory location. So in this case, processor wants to write 36 at 1000 memory location. So processor will give the control signal through the control bus that write. So processor will give the write signal through the control bus. It means processor wants to write. Now, after that, 36 will write at the 1000 memory location. Now, at the 1000 memory location, the data is 36. So, if the processor wants to write data at particular memory location, so first of all, processor will give the address on the address bus. After that, particular location will be select. After that, processor will give the data that processor wants to write through the data bus. After that, processor will give the control signal through the control bus. At last, at the 1000 memory location, 36 data will be write. Now, if at 3000 memory location, 65 is stored. Now, processor wants to read 65, which is present at the 3000 memory location. So, first of all, processor will give the address 3000 on the address bus. After that, in the memory, 3000 memory location will be select. Now, in the second step, processor will give the control signal through the control bus that I want to read. After that, 65 will, after then 65 will come on the data bus. And it will go through the data bus towards the processor. So if processor wants to read some data at a particular memory location, then first of all, processor will give the address on the address bus. After that, processor will give the control signal on the control bus. After that, data will come towards the processor through the data bus. So these three buses, address bus, data bus, and control bus, are collectively called the system bus. So today I discussed about the system bus. If you have any problem, please mention in the comment section. I hope you are satisfied with my today's discussion session. Thank you.